relationship could be with the kids, but overall, it's all about an issue of space and how relationships function in that space. So when I just heard you play the prelude part as opposed to the fugue, so okay, I didn't see how your improvisations relate to anything else that has happened. I agree with you that the character is that of a French author, and because of that, there are things that I'm going to move and hold back, and you're going to do some double dive and everything else. But it really has to be within the parameters of what you delineate as the beginning of the piece. If you have something that is suddenly very fast and then extremely slow, it's a bit of a compound on how to create a contrast that really is a little bit on the forced side. So, I don't do scordatura, but that's really besides the point. Now, the reason I said it's perfect weather for this prelude is that this is the darkest of all of the preludes. And have you ever heard this played on a lute?
No, I haven't heard it.
No?
No, I haven't heard it.
Alright, well, it's interesting to know that we don't have the manuscripts to the box beats. They are either lost or hiding in an attic somewhere. But we have the manuscripts of his wife, his student, Kellner, and two later ones that I'm not really sure how valid they are, since they're so much farther apart. But we do have the manuscript of the C minor suite in Bach's handwriting, but for Luke. Have you taken a look at that?
No.
It is really an eye-opener, because there is so much more detail in that than in the Anna Magdalena, for instance. There are notes that really make sense. He was so adamant about making sure that everything was given to you as opposed to really improvising it. And it seems that Magdalena took out a lot. And the reason I say Magdalena took out is because if you compare to Kellner, there are more notes in Kellner than there are in Magdalena. So it's very intriguing to think about it in those terms. And when you look at the manuscript of the lute version and listen to the lute version, it gives you a very different idea of what the suite could be about, as opposed to if you listen to a romantic cellist playing a piece. The first note of the piece is not just, it's actually the beginning of that overture. And if you were to orchestrate that beginning, you have a full C minor chord to start the proceedings. And that really is what determines the character of the piece. So you started with a, and then you get a, and I'm not really quite sure how those notes fit within the spectrum of what happens next. So now, it is written in Kafka. Let's start. And give me something that you are going from this big chordal structure. Imagine that you're playing an entire orchestra, you have this C minor chord, right? Then you have an improvisation that has to lead to. So it can't really be something that is twice as fast as that, especially since it's already written twice as fast. Try. Otherwise, Because in the piano, that's a completely different story. It will actually do what I would hope that the cello will do. There is a decay of the note. You cannot sustain through that tie. So it becomes... There will be a release based on the fact that the bow of the time period, as you drew the bow, the sound became less. Now, I don't want to hear a disappearance of the sound. That's not the point. But when you play a chord on the piano, you're like, tom, tom, and you know, there is a natural decay. That is what you're going to look for as you play. And not this. Or, as you play through many of the other chords, you play. You get an accent on the note following the time. So make sure that as you release, you feel that that note that starts the piece has the direction that will give the continuity to the line. Go for it.
Breathe.
You must suspend the amount of weight to compensate for that new speed that creates the accent in order to soften the blow of that new bow. Right. Right?
Yeah.
And if you end up with 30, you sped up, right?
Chill out.
Exactly. So in rubato, you you're going to take some time here, but you're going to put it here, so by the end, the metronome will have clicked 32 beats, and you're exactly right there with those 32 beats. All right?
Okay.
Great. Thanks a lot.